an answer. This is a story about the future can be scary. Unstable government, wars on every continent, famine, water shortages, environment. Where would you like me to start?
Well, you keep saying the future wasn't always this way. Tomorrow, shining at the end of every day, there's a great victory. It's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow. Sir?
May I help you?
My name is John Francis Walker. I'm here when it's the I took it apart because of the nitrogen compartment, seeing as how the bus ride was kind of bumpy. You know nitro. Engine. Bell Labs tested that with their rocket belt, and I guess there were some issues with maneuverability, flight duration, and stuff. It's a jetpack. Obviously.
You made this yourself.
Athena, what are you doing here?
Did you? No. Technically.
Good afternoon. Please step aboard the transport. Please put on your head protection in order to prevent significant injury.
Injury?
Thank you.
Identify yourself.
Nate, if you wake up dead, I will crush you.
You shouldn't sneak out.
But you shouldn't still need a puppy.
Dad says it's okay to sleep with.
That's because he doesn't want you to grow up.
Are you at the platform again? What do you do out there? Are you trying to stop them from taking it down?
That would make me a criminal and a pretty terrible role model to impressionable youth such as yourself. But if someone else did it, I'd have to assume they believed. Even the teeniest of actions could change the future.
How can you be sure?
Because I know how things work.
Why are they taking the platform down?
It's hard to have ideas. And easy to give up.
But you won't. Right?
Never.
How'd you do?
You would have gotten it.
Yeah, Eddie Newton.
What?
All three cranes. Hi, Douglas. Thanks for the call.
Everything okay?
Yeah, the equipment over at Canaveral's down again.
Weird. Really weird. Well, at least you get the day off.
Actually, they're bringing in replacement cranes from Orlando, so I will be back to work by noon.
That's fantastic.
Case.
Yeah?
Nothing's gonna stop him from taking down that platform. Nothing. And when we're done, I'm out of a job. There's nothing anyone can do about it. It's inevitable.
Well, then you'll find something else. You're a NASA engineer.
With nothing to launch.
There are two wolves.
Okay.
You told me this story my entire life, and now I'm telling you. There are two wolves, and they're always fighting. One is darkness and despair. The other is light and hope. Which wolf wins?
Come on, Case.
Okay, fine. Don't answer.
Whichever one you feed.
Good. Eat. Come on. Mutually assured destruction. Today, any nuclear country or terrorist is capable of inflicting damage on a massive scale with weapons of
environmental entropy. The polarized caps aren't waiting for us to decide if climate change is real. Rising coastal waters, intensifying weather patterns, they're all punching our one-way ticket to
dystopia. By definition, not perfect. Huxley's Brave New World, Bradbury's Fahrenheit 451, Orwell's 1984. Once considered fiction, these futuristic novels are actually happening right now, and they seem to be getting worse. Yes, Miss Newton.
Can we fix it?
Sorry?
I get things are bad, but what are we doing to fix it?
Have a good weekend, everybody.
Motorcycle's an impound. You can pick up your personal effects over there.
Newton, clip. $47.32. One Florida State driver's license, one baseball cap. Got one pin, one pack of Beeman's gum, and I don't know what this is. Send it here.
That's not mine.
What's not yours?
The pin. I've never...
Strings I had to pull to keep Homeland Security from pressing charges, Casey. This is not just vandalism, all right? It's NASA. It's government property.
Have you ever seen this before?
You're not getting it, are you? I am very upset with you.
I get it. You're angry. I understand, but I just need you to look at it. Does it look weird? Don't touch it!
Why are you yelling at me?
Not while you're driving, Dad. It's dangerous. Just pull over. Pull over.
I swear to God, Case, if you're on drugs,
I'm not on drugs. Just look. I need you to be NASA Dad now. New Frontier Dad, okay? All will be explained as soon as you touch this bit.
Thank you.
Swift.
Come on, idiots. It's gonna be late for R&D.
Transmit every day.
Even when you're out of range.
Come on, what's the big deal? We're only going 20 light years out. Do you know it?
You smell like swamp.
Tell me the password and you can go back to sleep.
Your phone has internet.
My phone got soaked in a lagoon.
Fine. What are we looking for?
Stop.
That's it. Stop. Extremely rare collectible pin commemorating the 1964 World's Fair.
Experts and purveyors of the most extensive selection of space age collectibles in the world.
Oh, this site is like ancient.
Okay, give me their number.
They don't have a number.
They don't have a number?
They have an address.
Okay, look. You are going to tell Dad you woke up, saw me leaving, I told you I was going camping with friends, and I will call tomorrow. Can you do that for me?
Only if you tell me what's going on.
I think that I saw. future. Can I come too? Not yet. Camping with some friends, she's gonna be gone for a couple of days. Is that what you told the pirates? Yeah.
But it's not true.
Yeah,
it is.
No, Nathan, it's not. Don't ask me how I know your name. I know it the same way I know that you are lying to me.
Are you from the future?
You clearly understand. So why aren't you telling me what I need to know?
That pen thing? It stopped working. She went to find another one.
Nathan, where is she looking?
Shells, 70% off.
Oh, no thanks. I'm not here to buy anything. I was hoping that you could tell me about this.
If I kept it open, it would ruin the effect, which is everything. Pardon my wife, she has no respect for showmanship. Hugo Kern's back. How may I help you?
She has a pen.
I saw that you were looking for one online.
Where did you get it?
What can you tell me about it?
I can't tell you anything about it unless you tell me who gave it to you.
I'm not going first.
Well, it seems our business here is done.
Seems it is.
Saw something, didn't you? When you touched it. Something incredible.
It's real?
Of course it is. Don't ask me how. These people have developed technologies we haven't even dreamed of yet.
Wait. What people?
Have you ever wondered what would happen if all the geniuses, the artists, the scientists, the smartest, most creative people in the world decided to actually change it? But where? Where could they even do such a thing? They need a place free from politics and bureaucracy, distractions, greed. A secret place where they could build whatever they were crazy enough to imagine.
Plus Ultra, they call themselves.
The only way to see it, however, is through contact with one of these.
Why did they make them? What are they for?
Rumor has it, they were about to go public. Share what they had built with the whole world.
Unfortunately, that never happened.
Why not?
I think we've shared enough, young lady. So, as we've decided to trust you, please, trust us. And tell me, where'd you get it?
I don't know.
What do you mean, honey?
I kind of got arrested and I was in with my stuff.
In with your stuff?
Yeah, I don't know how I got there. What was that?
Tell us who gave it to you, please.
No one gave it to me.
It's very unlikely, sweetheart.
You know what? I think I'm gonna go now. Thanks for your help.
$1,000 if you tell me where you acquired the pin.
I don't know.
$10,000.
Was it a girl? A little girl?
I don't know what you guys are talking about. Have a nice day. Enjoy your freak out.
Tell us where she is and you will be spared.
This
This is a joke, right?
Where's the girl?
Obviously. Ray, coming! Stop! gave my very last pin, young lady, and I'm not about to let it go to waste.
What do you mean your last pin?
Last pin.
Please, I saw it. It exists.
Of course it does. But if you don't come with me, it won't for much longer.
Why not?
Because they built something they shouldn't have.
Built what?
Do you want to keep asking me questions until someone arrives to murder us?
No.
Then which way do you want to go? Backwards? Or forwards?
And you can take me there?
I can.
I'm driving.
Okie dokie. You fellas are released, thanks. Alrighty, boys. Fire chief says we're clear to go in and poke around. Hopefully they were out for lunch and nobody was in there when she went boom.
Captain. Afternoon, sir. Dave Clark, Secret Service. Looks like you got yourself a doozy here.
Secret Service. Hey, where are they going?
They're securing the premises. Thanks so much for your help, but we're going to take it from here.
Hey, Dale! Found this just outside the window.
Ever seen anything like it?
What the hell? God almighty!
Sales! This week, 70%.
Was it a girl? A little girl? Was it a girl? A little girl?
You want to tell me what's going on here, son?
No, sir. I do not. Contact Governor Nix. Tell him we found the girl.
Villa!
Don't warn my heads up next time.
Hey, here's an idea. Why don't you just tell me where we're going?
Pittsfield, New York.
What's in Pittsfield, New York?
Someone who can guess us back in.
Hold on. You said that you gave me your last pin. How many other people did you give them to?
Most important.
Not even your first choice.
I found you a month ago and started wanting me to join Governor Corte. Which happens to be one of my search parameters for recruitment. Not to mention you scored a 73 on the Feynman Drummerberg scale.
73? Is that good? Wait, hold on. Recruitment for what?
I'm not allowed to answer that.
Who's not allowing you?
I'm not allowed to answer that, and I should warn you. You keep asking me questions, and my countermeasure protocol will initiate.
Okay.
Athena, started to think you were never coming home.
Where, oh where have you been?
Doing my job.
Your job? I'm sorry, were we not clear when we suspended your recruitment protocols?
I got that sense when you called me bloody obsolete and tried to disassemble me.
Well, you've certainly caused quite a commotion by launching an antique rocket ship out of the Eiffel Tower. Under normal circumstances, we'd be working overtime to convince everyone it was just an elaborate hoax. Fortunately for all of us, it doesn't really matter now, does it?
Why doesn't it matter?
And who might you be?
I'm Casey. Newton. And who might you be?
David Nix. Pleasure. Well, Frank, it's been wonderful catching up, but as we were fairly clear about the terms of your exile and the consequences of violating it, I have to ask, what the hell are you doing here?
I think she can fix it.
I'm sorry,
I think she can fix it, Dave.
Wait, what?
I've been pirating your signal. Every time you turn it on here, I can see it there. And it flickered. The percentage dropped, David.
Impossible.
You don't believe me? Let's go find out right now.
I'm sorry. What can I fix?
The world, Missy. He thinks you can fix the world.
Portal to Earth?
No, it is a bridgeway to Earth. Welcome back to the monitor, Frank.
It's something, is it?
Yeah, it's something.
Just be yourself.
Gotcha. What are those?
Flashes of future. This is us a few seconds from now. This whole tower funnels energy by a tachyon, a particle that moves significantly faster than light. We discovered them almost 40 years ago. Your physicists are still arguing over whether they exist. Too late. So, on with the show. We've enhanced the interface significantly, but it still functions on your original algorithm. You have something to show me, Frank?
Show me, Frank?
Show me.
A place.
What?
A location, anywhere in the world. Pick one.
Canaveral.
Cape Canaveral. Easy. The interface is oriented from your hands to the center of the Earth.
Trained her, obviously.
I just met her yesterday. She knows how things work.
How is this possible?
We are millions of exponential deviances away from the dimension you call home. Frank had the novel idea of building this machine so that we could keep in touch.
This is 3 days ago.
Relatively. Space-time humor. Because tachyons travel faster than light, once we harness them...
You can see backwards in time.
Not just backwards.
You're kidding.
No.
Keep going. Just a little further.
enough, kid.
My house.
Would have been nice if Frank had prepared you for this. I'm afraid the world is ending.
It is certain. It is unavoidable.
And it is coming.
When?
It's just 58 days.
58 days?
But whatever caused this could happen any time after the static starts. It could be a month. It could be sooner.
Still looking for your flicker, Frank.
I know what I saw.
So why aren't you telling anyone? The whole planet is gonna die, and you're just sitting here?
We're not gonna die.
This is your world, not ours. We'll be perfectly fine here.
Then why don't you let people in?
Tell her, Dave.
Oh, Frank.
All those years in exile, you still don't understand. These people, they're driven by savagery. If we told them about this place, then that would happen here to us. Then nothing would survive.
It hasn't happened yet.
Actually, it has happened. You just haven't accepted it.
Well, I don't accept it.
You see that? Did you see that?
Did you see it?
I know that you saw that. That means that there is a chance. There's at least a chance.
That went quite well, don't you think?
What happened? What happened?
You're being deported. Again.
Well, that's Nix for you. No new ideas.
Apparently your 1/10,000th variable in the inevitability wasn't convincing enough to change his mind. Be gentle.
You'd think somewhere in the zillions of questions that I was asking you, you could have said, oh, Casey, well, that stuff's not really the issue because our future predicting machine says we're all gonna die.
You did sort of hint at it. This place has nothing to do with hope.
It's the opposite of hope.
Come on, don't say that.
Why not? You said it. No wonder you gave up.
That's before I knew about you. You really, really, you really are special.
Why do you people keep saying that to me? I'm not!
Why'd you even give me this? You showed me a place that was amazing and incredible, and it was a lie! If you're gonna zap an idea into people's heads, you should really make sure that it's the truth, because you can't do that! You can't just zap!
What?
You're pirating the signal. How?
What?
At your house, all your TVs, your doomsday room. You were boosting the feed from that monitor thing. How did you do that?
No big deal. They're running so much power through it now. Ham radio could make it. Ham radio. Just a matter of finding the right frequency.
You grabbed a signal from another dimension. From a machine here. That means it's transmitting there. What if it's not just predicting the future?
It's broadcast.
When I touch this thing, for a few minutes, it felt like anything was possible, so then why can't the opposite happen? What if the monitor is just a giant pin? But instead of making you think positive, it makes you think negative, and it's convincing the whole world to feed the wrong wolf. We need to turn that thing off.
It's time to go home.
Uninhabited and uncharted.
Listen to me.
But it looks like a lovely place to spend your last days.
The monitor is acting as an antenna. It isn't just receiving tachyons. It is taking a possible future and making it
amplifying it, transmitting it like a feedback loop.
It's a self-fulfilling prophecy that's coming from right there.
It's not just showing people the end of the world. It's giving them the idea over and over
and
over again until they just accept
it. Bomb. And we're the ones that lit the fuse.
We still have 58 days to try and change things. Nothing.
will work as long as that thing is still on.
Young lady, I'm going to assume that your knowledge of tachyonic fusion is a little sketchy. Shutting it down is impossible. There is no off.
I'm telling you what it's doing. Why don't you care?
Because he's the one that's doing it.
Glimpse the future, you were frightened by what you saw. What would you do with that information? You would go to who? Politicians or captains of industry? And how would you convince them? Data, facts. Good luck. The only facts they won't challenge are the ones that keep the wheels greased and the dollars rolling in. But what if there was a way of skipping the middleman, putting the critical news directly into everyone's head? The probability of widespread annihilation kept going up. The only way to stop it was to show it, to scare people straight.
Because what reasonable human being wouldn't be galvanized by the potential destruction of everything they've ever known or loved? To save civilization, I would show its collapse.
But how do you think this vision was received? How do you think people responded to the prospect of imminent doom?
They gobbled it up.
Chocolate éclair. They didn't fear their demise. They repackaged it. It can be enjoyed as video games, as TV shows, books, movies. The entire world wholeheartedly embraced the apocalypse and sprinted towards it with gleeful abandon. Meanwhile, your Earth was crumbling all around you. You've got simultaneous epidemics of obesity and starvation. Explain that one. Bees and butterflies start to disappear. The glaciers melt. Algae blooms. All around you. The coal mine canaries are dropping dead, and you won't take the hint. In every moment, there is the possibility of a better future.
But you people won't believe it.
And because you won't believe it, you won't do what is necessary to make it a reality.
So you dwell on this terrible future.
You resign yourselves to it. For one reason. Because that future doesn't ask anything of you today. So, yes, we saw the iceberg. On the Titanic. But you will just steer for it anyway, full steam ahead. Why? Because you want to sink. You gave up. And it's not the monitor's fault. That's yours. Put them through.
Thanks for visiting, Frank. Genuinely nice to see you again. Yeah. What are you doing?
Not giving up.
Thank you. In time. I need to tell you something now. Oh, Don. I'm shutting down.
Shutting down?
I'm going to lose sync. Don't look at me like that.
If I lose sync, it's not failure.
I know.
Things I need to tell you before the final. Before the automated program kicks in. I'm a machine. I never thought that was bad until I saw your face when you found out who it was.
I always knew.
No, you didn't.
Systems failing. Activating last thoughts. Save for Frank Walker.
Log 15. September. 1965. Frank Walker is looking at me in a manner that is difficult to recognize. It seems imperative to explain to him that I'm an audio-animatronic.
Athena.
But I'm concerned that he may be adversely affected when he finds out that I'm not human. He has potential. I don't want to damage it. He needs someone to believe in him. And I am fulfilling that need. He's my top recruit. Log 24. October. 1965. I'm having unusual thoughts towards Frank Walker. I suspect a flaw in my empathy interface. I'm thinking I should report it. But I haven't. I cannot explain why. Log 78, April, 1984. Frank Walker has been banished by Governor Nix. He says he has lost hope, and he holds me responsible for having given it to him in the first place. I do not understand this. He says I never will, because I do not feel anger or disappointment or love.
End recording.
I was designed to find dreamers. I found you. And lost you. Till I found her. Casey. Dreamers need to stick together. It's not programming. It's personal.
The monitor. The bomb is gone. But I'm not. Yet. There isn't much time. My self-destruct. Use it. You know, this time.
I thought you can't have ideas.
Well, what do you know?
What do you know?
Systems failing. You want to know why goodness made me laugh?
Why?
Because you're not funny. You can let me go now.
Bye, Athena.
You're asking me?
This is your idea, kid. Your idea.
Yeah.
You think it'll work?
I guess we have to make it work.
So we're making it work.
First order of business, get the door back open. Couldn't hurt to get a few experienced engineers over here.
It isn't hard to knock down a big, evil building that's telling everybody that the world's gonna end. What is hard
is figuring out what to build in its place. And we're gonna do that. Can't do it alone. Need all of you.
Frank Walker, may I ask a question?
Sure.
The search parameters you've given us, while mathematically sound, are a bit undefined. Could you be more specific, please?
Well, Miss Newton, you want to tell our new recruiters what they're looking for?
Dreamers. We are looking for dreamers. Anyone who will feed the right wolf.
I once told your predecessor that she was nothing but a combination of ones and zeros. I was wrong. She was much more than that. You are much more than that. So, go out there and do what she would have done. Find the ones who haven't given up. They're the future.